Hello, here today I am showing you monochromatic landscape. Okay, monochromatic means what? Monochromatic means one color and its different shades. Okay, different shades when we make light, medium, dark, darkest. So only one color we have to use, and with its different shades and tints when we complete our full landscape, that is monochromatic landscape. Okay, for that now we are doing directly with brush. You are not going to use pencil. Okay, whatever is in your mind, you will do it directly with the brush. For that you require different sizes brushes, okay, and one color, whatever you take, and other coloring material. Now here I want to show you one monochromatic landscape. See, here you will see dark, this is darkest, okay, which things are in close. Here it is in your close. If camera will be here, you will get everything darker which is in close. Okay, then slowly it will become light. This area is full light, so that perspective will come in your landscape. Okay, take care while doing. This portion will be darker and slowly it will become lighter. Okay, so this is monochromatic landscape. Whatever scenery you want to do, you can do, but technique I'll show you. With that technique you will complete it. Okay, so like this you will draw margin on your paper first, and we'll start our landscape. I'll show you. Before start work, I will suggest you complete some paper work, rough practice. With that you will get good result. Okay, this is your paper and rough paper, and whatever color you are taking, one color, see, apply it. Pre-work, whatever you are doing, pre-work you will do. Okay, spread it immediately so that you will get. Then take different brushes, strokes you will do, strokes practice. Always when you go step by step with practiced rough practice, you will improve your strokes, lines. See, with different size brush, now I am doing these lines, you can make some straight lines. Okay, so this practice, rough practice, is very important. I'll make some dots even directly with brush. Whatever is possible, you continue practice. Straight line, horizontal line, curve line. Okay, so this will give you good result. There will be rhythm in your line, control on your line with this rough practice. So this is very important. Okay, so first you have to complete for 5 to 10 minutes. You will do a rough practice and then you will turn to your actual drawing. Now here for greeting card, I am doing this monochromatic landscape. So I am using this size of paper. Draw margin all side. Presentation is very important. So draw margin first. Okay, now we'll start our topic. After finish margin, we'll start our topic. See, now I'm taking large number brush so that I'll get nice mixing and fast. Now see what I'll do, I'll start from dark to light. Okay, this portion will be darker and slowly it will become light. If you want monochromatic, that's why only one color you have to use in different tones, light, medium, dark, darkest. So here is ground I'm making, which is very close for me. I'm making dark, and slowly with adding water I'll make it lighter. Okay, try that your color will not go out of margin, and then also if it will go, then you will make one black outline, bold outline. Okay, so this way you will complete your first basic application, light to dark, or if you can say dark to light. Okay, then hold your paper like this for 5 to 10 minutes. After dry, we will start next. Okay, so because I have habit, I can manage this weight to weight technique. Means on weight, if color will get spread, then also I can manage. So I'm starting immediately with medium size brush. I will draw with thick color. Now here I am using thick color for tree. See, in this also, if you want shading, immediately you will take little water and make light dark. One side I'll make light. And with pointed brush, you make its branches. Are you getting? This all branches you will do with pointed brush. With same pointed brush, you can make strokes for grass. Strokes, how it will be? From down to up. If you want, you can turn your paper. Then here it is again closed side, so I will add shadow, tree shadow. Sometimes details, means stones or whatever details you will get in close, that will do with dark color. Okay, I am doing this with dark color. Here for grass, I will do some details. So now, one more tree I want to draw, which is in perspective here. So that will come in medium tone. Okay, I will take medium tone for that tree, which will be, means it's looking on distance. Or you can add mountains, that's up to you. Okay, now which is in the close, we will work on that. See, now whatever leaves you want, leaves patterns, that you will do. Suppose I want this type of leaves, dot dot dot, I'll create so that I will get leaves. Or if you'll just touch brush hairs, you will get like this texture. It's up to your brush handling. If you want, you can do like this also. Means this technique you can use, you will get different type of leaves. I'll try to show you in this tree, which is very lighter. because this is in close, I have to do more details. Very easy technique it is. Everyone can do it very easily. Okay, so now I'll turn to this tree, which is lighter. Little dark tone I will add, but it should be lighter than this tree. Okay, then only you will get perspective. Okay, now I'm using different technique for the tree leaves. See, like this, and medium tone only to show distance. Okay, now its shadow. Scenery, you will decide what you want to do. Got it? Now this is dark and light, medium work is done. Sun, if you want, you can add sun here, which will be in shading, dark light. You can add some strokes in sky. Add some birds. Okay, and now I'm taking darkest tone, which will be thick, very thick. If you want, you can add little purple in the blue. In the red, even you can add little blue. Means don't add directly black. Instead of that, you can use any another colors, means related color, for dark shade. I'm making this darkest to make some details on this tree, because it is on the in the close, so I want to make some details. Some curve lines I'm going to do on this. Okay. So this is the way to complete your detailing. Here even I'll add some darkest tones, because it's very close. Even here I will add 2-3 lines to show perspective. With this we will get. Okay, here if you want, you can add some grass with lines. Again, pointed lines practice, if you do, you'll get it nicely. So this way you can complete your design. See, looking very nice. And after dry this, make outline. You can stick on color chart paper for your greeting card. If you want to mount it and make frame, then even mounting you will do with color chart paper, and as a painting you can hang it. Okay, so do it.